Morning students, today we are starting with adjective and comparison. Now we will learn first what is adjective, then we will move to comparison. So we are starting with adjective. An adjective is a word that describes a noun or pronoun. Now first of all, what is adjective? Adjective describes about noun and pronoun, means the word which have been used as noun and pronoun. So adjective describe them. It is used as a describing word. So adjective is known as a describing word, means the adjective word is doing is describing that this is noun or that is pronoun. Adjective can describe how much, how many, what color or number. Now what is the work of adjective? To describe that what is exactly, means how much. If you are going to buy something, we ask that how much rice you want, how many chocolates you want, what are the colors you require, or what are the numbers you require. Adjective can make a reading more interesting because they bring description to the noun. Now what the adjective work is? To describe the interesting word to the noun and pronoun. Most important, the description is given to the noun. Now we will go ahead to the adjective with the different kinds of adjective. So 5 different kinds of adjective. So we will be reading out the names. First, adjective of quality. Second, adjective of number and quantity. Third, demonstrative adjective. Fourth, possessive adjective. Fifth, integrative adjective. So now we will be moving with the explanation part. First, quality adjective. Among the different kinds of adjective, quality adjectives are probably the most common one. They simply say something about the quality or the kind of noun or the pronoun they are referring to. Now what is the work of quality? Quality means it differs to the thing which is known as a common one in all of the things, and mostly it gives a kind of noun or pronoun which is referring to the adjective. Means for example, quality means that boy is good. So what I'm mentioning about that boy? Quality, that he is good, he is smart, she is beautiful. So the words which you are providing, which you are giving to someone or to the self, is known as a quality. So what we see, if we go to buy something, what we see? The quality of the product. So means quality. These are some examples. Hina is naughty. Now naughty is her quality. She is tired. What she is? Tired. Now what she is? Tired. So that was a quality. Sam reflects are amazing. Amazing means when Sam comes. So his reflection is very amazing or amazing. So it is a quality. Now we are moving to second, the adjective of number or adjective of quantity. Now first we will understand, as the name suggested, the kind of adjective answers the question how many or how much. Now how many comes in numbers and how much comes in quantity. So how it comes, we will see in this. Adjective of number. Adjective of number answers the question how many. The are usually used to countable nouns, means if you are going to take something, so you are asking how many. How many you require means how many rows you require. Roses you can count, right? Right students, how many chocolates you require. So even I can count chocolate 1, 2, 3 like that. So things which we can count is known as a countable noun, or it is known as an adjective of number. This thing we have learned in our last videos of noun. Hope you all remember. So if you want, you can go back to our videos of noun and you can learn about countable and uncountable noun. So this is known as, how many is known as the adjective of number, means it is a countable noun. So these are the example of countable noun. There are 7 marbles in a box. So marbles, we play with marbles. So I can count marbles 1, 2, 3 like that. So how many marbles I'm having? 7. Many birds were flying over the tree. Means there are many birds. It may be 2, 3, 5, 10 like that birds. So there are many. So it is known as a countable noun. Now we are moving to quantity. Adjective quantity answers the question how much. They are usually used with the uncountable noun. Now, quantity means which things you cannot count. For example, can you count your hairs? No, because it is uncountable. Can you count price? No. Can you count milk? No. So for that we require how much liter you require water or milk. How much kg? How much kilo you require rice? So this all comes in how much, the things which you cannot count. It is known as uncountable. Now there are some examples of uncountable noun. Give me some money. Now how much money that child or that someone require, it's not mentioned, but he require some money. It may be 100, 200 like that. I don't have much work to do means he is having less work. That's why he is telling much means more work he is not having. He is having little work. So it is much work. So hope you students, you understood what is number adjective and quantity adjective. Number adjective means countable and quantity adjective means uncountable. So we are moving to our third adjective, that is demonstrative adjective. Demonstrative adjectives points out the pronoun and nouns and always comes before the word they are referring to. Demonstrative adjective in English are these, that and those. Now what is the work of demonstrative pronoun? It always point out noun and pronoun. But before using noun and pronoun, what the demonstrative adjective is doing? He is giving his word as a starting word, and with that word he is continuing noun or pronoun in that sentence. So the demonstrative adjective words are these, that and those are the words which we start with the sentence. This is my friend, right? So this is my friend. Those are beautiful. Those flowers are beautiful. So like this sentence are used. So we will check out some examples. I used to buy these kinds of shirts. Now what you used to buy? This kind of shirts. When the old man tripped over that wire, he dropped a whole bag of grocery. Means one man got stuck because of wire. He tripped, means he didn't saw the wire and that wire got stuck on his leg and he fell down. So all the groceries which were in his hand all fall down. I don't like those curtain. What? Those. So these are the words, means these words. It's not like that the starting only it is used, but it is used like the adjective words in between of pronoun and noun. These, that, those are the words known as demonstrative pronoun. Now we are moving to the fourth one. Possessive adjective. Obviously this kind of adjective shows the ownership or the possession. Aside that, possessive adjective always come before the noun. Now possessive noun always come before noun means when we start the word, so sometimes the possessive noun comes before the word, and before the noun is known as the possessive words are my, his, her. All these are known as possessive noun. So we will check out some examples of possessive noun. So these are some examples of possessive noun. First, my friend live very close to my house. Now who is living close to? My means my is a possessive word. Trisha sold his dog. What she sold? His dog. Means she was having dog and she sold it. Her suitcase is not properly locked. What is not locked? Her suitcase. Means who's her? She may be my neighbor, she may be my friend, or she may be someone whom I don't know. So her suitcase was not locked. So these are the possessive noun. My, his, her are all known as a possessive noun. Now we are moving to the fifth one. Integrative adjective. Integrative adjective ask the question and are always followed by noun. They are who, which, what, when and whose. Now integrative adjective work is to ask the question. So when we ask question, what words we are using? What is your name? How old are you? Which book is your? Where do you stay? So this which, what, where, when, who, all this word is meant for asking questions. So like this word are been asked before and then the question is been asked. So we will check out some question. Sorry, some example. What movie are you watching? So this is a question. So what I used here? What? Which plant should be placed over here? Which? Again question. Whose bag is this? Now again whose is known as a question. Now here we have finished up with adjective. Now we are moving to our degree of comparison. So these are our degree of comparison. Degree of comparison. Imagine changing the temperature on your air conditioner. The air conditioner has a different degrees of temperature you can select. Adjective have different degrees as well. Now what is degree of comparison means? Now everyone is having air conditioner or AC at their home, right? So there are temperature which we can set. So we are having remotes which we use a remote, and the temperature which we require 25, 26, 30, 24, 20, whatever degree temperature we want to set, we are setting. So like that, the comparison of degree of adjective is also known as well. So there are different degrees of adjective. There are three degrees of adjective are positive, comparative and superlative. When you use them, depends on how many things you are talking about. Now there are three different adjectives of comparison degree. Positive. So what is positive, what is comparative and what is superlative, we will learn one by one. Positive adjective. A positive adjective is a normal adjective that's used to describe, not compare. For example, this is good soap and I am funny. So these are the positive word, means I am telling as this is a good soap. I am funny means I am talking about myself. So here, like, simple word I use, funny, tall, big, like this simple word is used as a positive adjective. Now we are moving to comparative adjective. Comparative adjective is an adjective that used to compare two things and is often followed by the word then. For example, this soup is better than that salad. I am funnier than her. Now in positive, what we have learned? This soup. This is good soup, right? We have learned that. This is good soup. But in comparative, what we have learning? This soup is better than that salad. Means two different words, but comparing one word has better. I am funnier than her. Now we are moving to superlative adjective. A superlative adjective is an adjective that used to compare three or more things or the state that something is most. For example, now what is the work of superlative? To use three different words to make a sentence. This is the best soup in the whole world. Now first was, this is the best soup. So that soup was given. So instead of good, what they have taken? Best. So like that, three different words has been added and made, this is the best soup in the whole world. Or I am the funniest out of all the bloggers, means for in positive it was I am funny, and in comparative it was I am funnier than her. And now here I am the funniest out of all other bloggers. So we will just check out simple way of how to understand positive, comparative and superlative. Examples of positive, comparative and superlative degree. Large means positive, larger means comparative, largest means superlative. Okay, big, bigger, biggest, tall, taller, tallest, hard, harder, hardest. These are the superlative, comparative and positive degrees of comparison. So hope students you all understood what is adjective and what is degree of comparison. And in degree of comparison, we have learned three different degrees: positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. And in adjective, we have learned five different kinds of adjective. One was quality, second was number and quantity, third was demonstrative, fourth was possessive, and fifth was integrative. So hope you all got what is adjective and degree of comparison. Thank you.